With the new reporting module, you can improve your productivity and efficiency with onboard computer data. The reporting module provides a number of basic reports for common KPIs. Thanks to the predefined or configurable filters and drill-down functions, fleet management can zoom in on the data that is important to them. To gain access to the reporting module, you have to log in to Fleet Cockpit. There you can click on the reporting icon in the menu bar. The main screen is always the overview dashboard. With the menu bar in the top right corner, you can navigate in the reporting module. The overview dashboard gives you an overview of your FMS data. Move your cursor over the graphs to display exact numbers. If you move over the graphs, you get to see two symbols in the top right corner to maximize the graph or to display the data in another kind of graph via the view selector or to export it to a PDF or Excel file via Export As. You can also consult more detailed reports of drivers, vehicles, telephone data and alarms. First click on Overview in the top left and select Detailed Reports. Then you can switch between the different reports by clicking the report title. The driver activity report is automatically opened when you switch from overview to the detailed reports for the first time. This report displays all data of the activities of your drivers. Also here you get more information when you move your cursor over the graphs, and you have the same options to visualize graphs differently, export them or maximize them. If you want to filter on one or multiple drivers, click the filter button in the menu bar. And when you click on driver, you have the option to filter on driver group or driver. In the next screen, you select the concerning drivers or driver groups. On the left side of the screen, you can still apply other filters. Instead of filtering on number of days, you can also filter on last month or set a date range. Depending on your choice in this box, you have two other filter options. When you filter on the number of days, you can edit the number in the second box, which is automatically set to 7, and you can select the start date in the third box. When you select last month, you cannot change the other options because you get to see the data of the previous month. When you choose to select the date range, you can select the start and end date in the second and third box respectively. Then you can also filter on activity type. These activities are client-specific, so you will see your own activities. You could, for example, choose to only display data of the activities driving and logout. When you check these boxes, the data adapts automatically. Besides the activity report of drivers, you can also consult the activity report of your vehicles. Click the report title to change reports and select Vehicle Activity Report. As in the previous reports, you get to see more information and options when you move over the graphs. The filters also function the same way, as well those on the left as those with the filter button. Only here you have the option to choose one or more vehicles or vehicle groups instead of drivers or driver groups. Next, you can consult the telephone report. Once again, click the report title and select Telephone Report. Here you see all telephone data of your drivers. Once again, you can work the same way with the graphs and filters as in the other reports. At last, you can consult the alarm and event report. Click the report title again and select Alarm and Event Report. As in the other reports, you can use the same filters as well as see more information when you move over the graphs. On the left side, you have an extra filter, Event Type, which you can set to alarm or event, depending on which type of data you want to display. Besides that, you can also filter on event. These are basic events that are based on our trace types. If you want more information about the reporting tool, please contact your project manager. Fleet Cockpit Mobile is our new web application that in an easy and user-friendly way allows you to follow up your fleet when you're not in the office. The app is included for free in your Fleet Cockpit license. To access Fleet Cockpit Mobile, you have to open a browser on your smartphone and go to fleetcockpitmobile.trimbletl.com. You can log in with your existing FleetWorks or Fleet Cockpit account. When you are logged in, all units are visualized on the map. In the search bar on top of the screen, you can select all units, unit groups, or one specific unit. When you click on the settings button in the top right corner, you get access to the map menu. Here you can change the style of the map and choose whether you want to display traffic information and truck attributes on the map. On the map, you see units as markers or clusters. Markers represent one single unit and clusters are a group of multiple units in one area. All units are automatically grouped to a cluster when you zoom out. A marker contains information about the unit, such as the unit name and speed. The direction of the unit is indicated by a black arrow. The color of the marker corresponds with the color of the activity that is being executed at that moment. When you click a marker, a pop-up appears with more detailed information, as well as two buttons which you can use to go to the alarms or messages of the unit. The button in the middle allows you to call the unit or driver. Clusters show the number of markers in the middle. The colors of the clusters correspond to the colors of the markers and indicate to what extent a certain activity type is being used in that area. In this example, the cluster contains 13 markers and the activity driving is represented in purple. More purple on the cluster means that more units are driving at that moment. With Fleet Cockpit Mobile, you can also consult alarms or messages of units. Tap the menu button in the top left corner to open the menu and select alarms. By default, all alarms are displayed. With the search bar on top, you can choose to display alarms of a unit group or a specific unit. The list of alarms is completed further when you scroll down. Tap on an alarm to see more detailed information. Select messages in the menu to consult all messages. Messages and alarms function the same way. Again, you can use the search bar on top and scroll through the messages list. Tap on a message to display the full text. You can consult messages and alarms of the past 7 days. To end with, you can modify certain settings. Go to the settings menu. Here you can choose which information is displayed on the markers. Speed, asset type, direction, and unit name. This was the last part of this presentation of Fleet Cockpit Mobile. If you have any further questions, please ask them in the chat box of this webinar.